you've got a remarkable story. After you graduate high school, you're playing semi-pro football mm-hmm. when a college coach recognizes, sees you, this kid might have some talent. If that doesn't happen, where are you right now?
Oh man, who knows? You know, my mother was praying for me. You know, a lot of prayers went up. You know, blessings came down. But yeah, I was playing semi-pro coming out of high school. I didn't take my grades as serious as I should have, and I just wanted to still play the game. So a few buddies of mine told me about this semi-pro team. They don't pay you or nothing, but you can play ball still. So I'm like, I was playing for free in high school. So.
All conference, junior and senior year in college, fourth round pick of the Cardinals. Now you're here with the Colts. This is a heck of a story when you think about it, you know?
Sometimes it's surreal, you know, you just sit back some time and just take a deep breath and take it all in like, man, I'm here.
A couple of injuries, one in Arizona, and then last year here. You did something, though, you know, I talked about this off camera. You did something in the off season, though, that really has changed your season, maybe your career.
Basically just went back to the roots, you know, went back home and worked out with my coaches that been coaching my entire childhood, you know. Yeah. My track coach, he told me just by watching games, we kind of got distance when I went to Arizona, you know, just with the league just moving as fast as it does, you know, with meetings and practice, you know. So he was telling me a long time ago, man, I think I can correct your running style. And I'm like, I'm still fast, you know, but he's telling me, like, I see a drag in your run, simple stuff. And so yeah. I'm like, okay, maybe he's right. Let me go home and see if we can tune up the body some more. And I guess it's working so far.
It's like going back to your sensei or something.
Yeah,
you know, you just kinda, there's some chi there.
Yeah, you know I have everything in the NFL at my disposal. And it's like, how can this man that don't really, you know, it's not about the money. It's not about how many professional people I can go to get right. this. It's like he just knows me, knows my body, and he kind of just put it in line, I guess.
Last thing I read where you wear a new pair of shoes every day of the week. Where does this come from?
I have to say, when I was young, you know, my brother, he played basketball. My Aunt Penny, she's in the WNBA, and she always kept her shoes nice and neat. And I always used to, like, man, I wish I had a lot of shoes like her, you know.
So now you're getting plea, you get a little money, okay.
Yeah, that's my
thing. I need some new shoes.
Yeah, that's my thing. You know, I don't have a lot of, like, you know, fetish, like cars or, you know, jewelry and stuff. I like shoes, yeah. So.
Shoes are a lot less expensive than cars and jewelry. So you might have chosen wisely on that one.
I have a shoe room, actually.
Yeah. You have a shoe room?
Yes, Vontae jokes me about it all the time. He comes to my house, he comes in the room like, bro, every from wall to wall, it's just dress shoes over here,
yeah.
You know, and workout shoes over there, so.
I personally think this is fine. I have no problem with this, so.
Yeah.
Mr. Shoe, Greg Toler.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.